name is Ru Huang. I'm the second year DMA student in voice performance and literature at the University of Illinois.
Hello everyone, my name is Yarong Guan, and I'm also a second year DMA student majoring in piano performance and literature here at UIUC.
We are very delighted to present today's concert in celebration of Asian Americans' Heritage, Pacific Islanders Heritage Month.
And special thanks to the Spurlock Museum, thanks to Kim, thanks to Brian, and all the other crews. Without you guys' support, this concert would not be happening.
We want to share some of our stories with you before the music starts, and we welcome you to the concert. And when I was a little kid, I started singing in the children's choir and playing my instruments. Around 6 years old, I remember my mom would play Mozart in the living room, and we would also watch the national voice competitions on TV. I remember people were singing all different kind of music and bel canto aria. I did not know what that meant until in my undergraduate, I had my first chance to watch the opera Madama Butterfly, and I was so moved. I was crying in the audience, and I decided, okay, I'm gonna pursue singing in my graduate study. So here I am, and I never stopped singing other styles of music. I just really enjoy music and singing, and I also never gave up my instrument. It's called erhu. Somewhere here is a two-string fiddle. I will show you guys a little bit. It's a two-string fiddle. Erhu means er means two, so which means like two strings, and a hu is like this little space here of the instrument. And music has always been a very important part of my life, and it gives me power when I go through struggles, frustration. And when I'm in my down times, and I'm really appreciated to share my music today with you guys.
Wonderful. So I would also like to share a little story of myself with you guys. So when I was very young, probably second grade, my parents, they showed me to a piano school. They want to see if I am interested in learning piano. And the teacher showed me around, and I get to play a couple of notes. And I think the sound was okay. And then I saw a bunch of kids playing outside. So I asked the teacher, if I study piano, do I get to play with all the kids? And the teacher was like, yes. So when my parents asked me if I want to study piano or not, I told them, of course. But the real reason is like, I would like to play with the kids, because during the summer, I don't want to be alone by myself at home like every day. With a couple of years of very hard practicing, I got into the conservatories, like top four conservatories. And later, I was awarded full scholarship here at UIUC, and I am a doctoral student now. I think with studying piano, I get to know so many wonderful peoples, and I get to travel around the world to play with orchestras, and I also I also get to listen to a lot of wonderful concerts. Piano has always been my best friend and a great support of me. And when I feel alone, I always practice the piano. It's always the best accompaniment. Now, when I look back, I think back in that summer, I made my best choice ever. So today, we would like to share some music from our heart.
Yeah, music is a universal language, and it speaks for itself. So today, our programs will include
some popular music, traditional tunes from Asian countries, and also classical piano repertoire, and some Shanghai jazz style pieces.
Yeah, we know this is only going to be a little bit of the Asian American heritage, but we also want to share today's program to bring out the different music cultures of communities. And please enjoy. And we will present our first two pieces, Racing Horses and the Preface, to the poems collected from the Orchid Pavilion. So Racing Horses was composed by Hai Huai Huang in 1959. And it was first premiered in 1964 in Shanghai Spring Music Festival. So this piece is a very classic piece of the Chinese instrument erhu, and it depicted a grand occasion of a group of horse racing. And the second piece, Preface to the Poems Collected from the Orchid Pavilion, was a very popular song, actually composed by one of the most famous popular singers, Jay Cho, in 2011. And the song lyrics was originally adapted from the calligraphy by the famous artist Xi Zhiwang. The song lyrics was expressing this culture. He wants to pursue his love throughout his whole life without carrying all of the judgment around him. And please enjoy.
So the next piece I'm going to play is called Colorful Clouds Chasing the Moon, or 彩云追月. This piece was written by a Chinese composer, Jian Zhongwang, and it employs a lot of dotted rhythm like tum, 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 tum. It's like a dance pattern, and it also employs a lot of pentatonic scales. You will hear the octaves in higher registration gradually coming down, and that depicts a picture of the colorful clouds chasing the moon. The next piece I'm going to play is called Xiao and Drums at Sunset. This piece was popularized since the Ming and Qing dynasty. It was originally composed for Chinese instrument pipa. Later, it was transposed into guzheng. And for guzheng composition, the name is called Spring River, Flower, and Moonlight, or 春江花月夜. So please enjoy.
Thank you.
gonna present four pieces featuring voice and erhu. And the first piece is called Give Me a Kiss. It is a popular song, a remusic published from English popular songs called Seven Lonely Days by Georgia Gibbs in 1953 and got very popular by Teresa Teng's cover. And the second one is Evening Promises. It was a popular song in 1944 and was originally sung by the Chinese-Japanese singer Xianglan Li, composed by Jin Guangli, pioneer of the Chinese popular music history, and the whole song depicted a calm night scenery. And the third piece is the Marching to the Bright Future. It was composed in 1930s by Tianhua Liu, and this piece was composed during the composer's very downtime. So at that point, he thinks the traditional instruments actually descending and may not get better, so he created this piece to get people motivated. And the fourth one is called Sakura, and you can also call it the cherry blossom. It depicted the season of the spring, and it is a very traditional Japanese folk tunes, and today we're gonna perform these folk tunes combining with the contemporary composition by Yasuko Kiyoda. Please enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you.
So the next piece I'm going to perform is a piano solo. It's called Arirong. Arirong is a traditional Korean folk song. Ari means beautiful, and rong means beloved ones. And my favorite lyrics of the original song is, "There are so many stars in the sky, just like there are so many dreams in our heart." The next piece is called Jasmine Flower or Mo Li Hua. It is a traditional Chinese folk song from the Jiangnan region. The melody is so well known in China, it is like a cultural symbol of China. The melody has also been well known by the Western listeners, as it was borrowed by a French composer, Puccini, in his opera, Turandot. The piece after that is called Pecking Opportunes, or Pi Huang. The title of this piece, Pi represents CP, and Huang represents Er Huang. They are two kinds of voice types used in the Peking operas. There are so many rubatos or freedom in this piece, just like the Peking operas. The very first tempo marking in this piece is rubatos, which is very different from traditional Western markings like allegro, presto, allegretto. For this one is full of freedom and rubatos. So hope you will like it.
Thank you.
Rose, Rose, I Love You, and A Glass of Wine. The Love You Can Get was a popular song in 1967, was originally sung by Yao Li and got so much popular by Teresa Teng's cover, and it's the same thing with the Roses, I Love You. It was a 1940s Mandarin popular song by Chen Gexin, and it also got very popular when Teresa Teng was covering it. And it was later covered by an English man called Frankie Lane in 1951. A Glass of Wine is a Chinese folk song, and the lyrics is talking about my love is just like a glass of wine, so tasty and sweet. Please enjoy.
part, standing on the jetty as the steamer moves away. Flower of Malaysia, I cannot stay. Flower of Malaysia, I cannot
Mozart Sonata by Yarong for you guys for encore today. Hope you like it. Thank you. Thank you so much for coming. Our concert finished at this moment. We want to thank you so much again for being here to have the chance to share our music with you. We also want to thank the Spurlock Museum again. Thank you, Kim. Thank you, Brian. Thank you, Emily, Elena, every crew. We are so appreciated. And we hope to see you next time. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, guys. See you next time.